Well, in Senate testimony yesterday, FBI Director Christopher Wray said the ongoing war in the Middle East has raised the threat of a terrorist attack in the U.S. to a heightened level. Now, this comes even as the Biden administration's failure to enforce border protocols led to record migrant crossings throughout this year, with more than 1.7 million known gotaways. That's individuals who were evading. You know, so many of these come over and they just say, hey, here I am, take me in, and they get a free pass into the country. Well, if that's the case, why would you want to evade being caught? Because they're just, it's called catch and release. They catch them, give them a sheet of paper, and they let them go. So why would you evade being caught unless you have something to hide? Now, the Republican senators held a press conference earlier today, in part addressing this issue. Clip five.
The odds that terrorists are coming across our southern border into the United States are increasing on an hour-by-hour basis. Afghanistan, Lebanon, Somalia, Russia, more than 500 crossed here from those countries last month. People there, they hate us. So we should be prepared that they could attack us from within.
That was Montana Senator Steve Daines earlier this morning, and now he's with us this afternoon. Senator Daines, welcome back to Washington Watch.
Hey, good to be with you, Tony.
Now, you've been outspoken on this issue. What threats do we face due to the Biden administration's mishandling of our southern border?
You know, Tony, over the course of the last several weeks, I've stood on two borders. In late August, I stood on the Israel-Lebanon border, seeing the Hezbollah terror tunnels. 2 weeks ago, I was on the Texas-Mexico border, looking firsthand at what's happening on the southern border. I think what's not being fully communicated or understood by so many Americans is that what's coming across the southern border is not just Central Americans, Mexicans, South Americans. It is individuals from states that are bastions for known terrorist entities like Cuba, Iran, North Korea, Syria, Lebanon. The San Diego Border Patrol issued a warning bulletin about a week and a half ago, and it said, we need to be on the watch for Hamas terrorists coming across the southern border. As you just pointed out, Tony, the folks that are coming across the border, 8 million since Biden took office, the ones that throw their arms up, I don't worry a lot about them, although we have encountered nearly 200 on the terror watch list, the FBI watch list.
Right.
I worry about those, they call, as you said, the 1.7 million known gotaways. That means we laid eyes on them, we saw them in the video camera, but never were able to encounter them. But even beyond that, when I chatted with Border Patrol in Texas, I asked them, well, how many do we think are coming across that are the unknown gotaways? In other words, we have no idea. And they said, well, by definition, we don't know, but we think it's another 50%. So take that 1.7 million known gotaways, add maybe another 50%, so another 800,000, 900,000. We have no idea who these people are. But we do know is there are people coming in from countries that are on terror watch lists and from countries that harbor terrorists and seek to destroy us.
Is it safe to say, given our liberal immigration policy, which is no policy at all, you just kind of come in, as you said, throw up your hands, you get a piece of paper to report to a court date, 12 months later, and you're let go into the country. Is it safe to say then those who are intentionally evading capture that they may have something to hide?
Well, I think that's human nature. If you have nothing to hide, you're not afraid to be captured. If you have something to hide, you avoid capture. And this is what worries so many of us. So just think about that for a moment. You know, 1.7 million people have come across the southern border that we don't know who they are. We know they came across because we laid eyes on them either physically or through a video camera. But again, another 800,000 on top of that, we have no idea when they came or where they came from. But we already know there are thousands and thousands coming across from states that harbor terrorists. So I'm very worried, Tony, as we're seeing what's happening in the Middle East, the horrible attacks from Hamas, that will inspire perhaps lone wolves in our country, like we saw happen in Belgium when those two Swedes lost their lives, murdered by Islamic terrorists. But this could inspire radicals. It also could release terror cells that are going to have premeditated kind of attacks here. This is a very, very dangerous time for our country. And I hold Joe Biden and the Senate Democrats accountable for this because it's their policies that put us in this mess.
I think the probability of something more than just lone wolf action is quite significant when you consider the number of people who have come across the border and the cell groups, the terrorist cell groups that could have been assembled here in this country. I want to go back to Israel. I've been to the northern border there with Lebanon. I've been to the southern border there on Gaza, and I've seen the elaborate security that the Israelis have. But even then, with the elaborate security, the balloons monitoring, the walls, the fences, all of that was still breached. And given the fact that they put so much effort into it, but still were at risk, what does that tell us about our condition?
Well, it's concerning, Tony. And some of the most important intelligence when you're working with less sophisticated terror organizations is human intelligence. That's probably one of the failures that happened in Gaza was a breach in human intelligence. But I'll tell you, when I saw those Hezbollah terror tunnels just that last week of August, I was the last senator to meet with Bibi Netanyahu in Jerusalem prior to the October 7th attacks. And what did I talk with Bibi there? It was Iran, it was Hamas, it was Hezbollah. In those Hezbollah tunnels, spray painted on the inside, saw with my own eyes, it says, on our way to Jerusalem. It's written in Arabic, on our way to Jerusalem. Look, this is premeditated planning. They were hoping to have thousands of Hezbollah terrorists come through these tunnels with a northern invasion. We're very concerned about that northern border escalating because Hamas is kind of the junior varsity as it relates to a terror organization in Gaza. Hezbollah would be a Division I team. And they have 150,000 rockets pointed at Israel in southern Lebanon, embedded in hospitals, in mosques, in schools, using human shields. Of course, terrorists value death. They aspire to death. The Israelis protect life. And this is one of the challenges they face right now with this current terror threat.
So, quickly, on these tunnels that were uncovered there in the north, was it suspected that those were going to be used for a coordinated attack from the north based upon what Hamas was doing on the south?
Yes. Thankfully, the Israelis discovered these tunnels. These tunnels started construction back in 2014, 9 years ago. I mean, it was very archaic technology used to get through these sandstone hills in Lebanon that border Israel. But I was able to descend with an IDF soldier there just 7 weeks ago, down 80 feet below the surface of the ground, and then across until they finally filled it with concrete once the Israelis got onto what the Hezbollah was doing. But this is just a tinderbox right now, Tony. And this is why we've got to hold Iran accountable for it. This is why we need moral clarity from President Biden and leaders in Washington to, one, unequivocally stand with Israel, unequivocally let Israel do what it has to do to protect itself. That's going to be a long, drawn-out war going into Gaza to eradicate Hamas. But if the Iranians decide to signal to Hezbollah to end the conflict from the north, then it's erupting into something else. It's very concerning because it starts to overwhelm capabilities there in Israel with that some 150,000 rockets pointed from Lebanon.
Right. Yeah, we cannot handcuff them. We have to let them take care of their security there in Israel. Senator Steve Daines, always great to see you. Thanks so much for taking time to join us today.